What is the best protein food source? Do we need meat for protein? Can we be healthy without it? Let's find out. What's going on? This is Nutrition Made Simple. On this channel, we break down the science of food for your everyday use. If you're confused about what foods are healthy and which foods are not, then these videos are for you. Protein. We worry about getting more, about not getting enough, about getting the best. Protein is an obsession, and yet we know almost nothing about it. So this is the first of a series of videos I'm going to make about protein. We're going to cover everything we need to know in order to have a healthy diet and never have to worry about protein ever again. Sound good? In this video, we're going to focus on protein sources, which foods have it, which foods don't, and how much. Just to keep things interesting, quick question. Which food has the most protein? Is it beef, hemp seeds, eggs, or peanuts? Assuming same amount, say 1 ounce of each. Beef is about 26% protein, very substantial amount. So in a 4 ounce steak, about 1 ounce of that is protein. Now, if I showed you these 12 foods in order of their protein content, from low to high, and asked you to guess which are animal and which are plant foods, most people would guess something like this. Animal foods being the best sources and having the most protein, and plants with the least. And yet, reality is a little different. There's the beef with 26%, that's chicken, that's eggs, and that to the left is milk. In the middle here we have peanuts, 26% protein, same as beef. To the right of beef we have hemp seeds with more than 30% protein. And on the right we have seitan at 75%. So am I saying that we should all start eating seitan 3 times a day? No. Seitan wouldn't even be one of my top recommendations since it's technically not a whole food. This is just to illustrate the point that protein is everywhere. All animal foods have protein, and all plants have protein. The exact amount varies from food to food. It varies among the animal foods, and it varies among the plant foods. But whether you eat animal products, or just a variety of plant foods, you're gonna get all the protein you need. And in fact, studies have shown that vegetarians, pescatarians, vegans, and omnivores all comfortably exceed the recommended amounts of protein. And on a personal note, here are my protein levels from the last decade or so. The green shows the normal range. Before 2011, to the left of the red line, I was eating meat, dairy, etc., like most people. And after that, I made the changes to my diet and dropped all those foods. So you can see there's not much change, and it's perfectly normal throughout, even though I haven't had a steak in 7 years, no chicken, no dairy, and I eat fish and eggs less than once a year in average, so basically never. But I do eat 100 grams of protein, give or take, every day. So the bottom line is we don't depend on animal products to get protein, and if we stop eating them altogether, we're not gonna just keel over and die of malnutrition. Now, this reality is very surprising to many of us, myself included. 10 years ago, I would have been very surprised to find this information, as indeed I was when I found it. And the reason it's so surprising is that we are taught from a very early age that protein equals meat. This idea is all around us. Chefs call meat the protein. Go to Chipotle, ask for rice and beans. The guy behind the counter will ask you, what about protein? Your plate is already packed with it. Here's another quick example to drive this point home. Let's say I wake up and have a bowl of oatmeal and a peanut butter sandwich. A couple hours later, I snack on some almonds. Lunchtime, lentils, rice, and some broccoli. One banana for dessert. How much more protein do you think I need over the rest of the day in order to meet my daily requirements? The answer is zero. The oatmeal, peanut butter sandwich, the handful of almonds, and that light lunch add up to 56 grams of protein. That's the daily requirement for the average man. If you're a woman, you've already exceeded your daily requirements by 10 grams. And it's just after lunchtime. Now, if you're very active, you can have a bit more. If you lift a lot of weights, you can have a bit more. And in the example, you still have dinner and whatever meals in between to go, so you're gonna eat more. And that's fine. The example doesn't add up to enough calories for the day. Plus, the protein doesn't get absorbed 100%. We'll get into that in due time. But the point here is just how easy it is to get large amounts of protein. It's everywhere, it's abundant, and it's not a concern. Now, some of you may look at this example and go, oatmeal, lentils, this stuff doesn't fill me up. First of all, it's a lot more filling than you think because it's packed with fiber. But let's say it doesn't fill you up. Great, eat more. That's exactly my point. This is not a lot of food. We didn't have any steaks, no chicken, no fish, no dairy, and yet it's packed with protein. Maybe you don't like one of those foods. Maybe you don't like broccoli or lentils. No problem, eat something else. tons of options. You're not stuck with any one food. Now, whether you're trying to reduce your intake of meat or not, I highly recommend everybody eat more legumes. That's things like chickpeas, beans, lentils, peas. They are packed with protein. In fact, they're probably the best protein source in nature. And they're consistently associated with a lower risk of heart disease and longer life expectancy. And we're not eating enough of them. 96% of people in the US don't meet their daily requirements of legumes. So we really can't go wrong with more legumes in our diet. Okay, so today hopefully we've established that A, plants have protein, B, all plants have protein, and C, they have tons of it. Now I know some of you are jumping out of your seat going, protein is not all the same, amino acid composition differs, absorption differs, bioavailability. Bear with me. We're going to cover everything we need to know over the course of this series. So subscribe below so you don't miss any of the upcoming ones. Today, we focus on the abundance of protein in all natural foods. We will continue on the next one, so stay tuned, and I will see you very soon.